So today we're going to talk about how we can use concealer to do something about those dark greenish gray under eye circles. And this morning happens to be a great time to do it because I binged on Netflix last night and this is the end result that I'm dealing with. When working with concealers, you need to take into account the type of foundation you're wearing. Is it liquid, cream, or powder? The type of concealer you're using, cream or powder or liquid, usually it's cream or powder, as well as when to apply it, how and where to apply it. The general rule of thumb is wet before dry. So if you're wearing a liquid or cream foundation and a cream concealer or liquid concealer, you can apply the order concealer first, then foundation, foundation, then concealer, it doesn't matter. If you're wearing a pressed powder or loose powder foundation with a powder concealer, again, it doesn't matter the order you apply it. But you do not want to apply a liquid or cream concealer after a powder foundation. You're gonna get a little bit of goo. So if you're using both, you wanna apply the cream or liquid concealer before you apply your pressed powdered foundation. Today I'm wearing our BB Flawless Complexion Enhancer, which is like a tinted moisturizer with just a little bit of extra oomph. And I do want a little more coverage, so I'm mixing in our concealer in satin, which is my skin tone. This gives me just a little bit of extra coverage. Now this next step took me a little while to get used to, but hang with me because I think you're really gonna like the end results. What I do is I apply my foundation to my forehead and down into this area here. I do my brows and all of my eye makeup before I apply any foundation or concealer to the rest of my face. Next, I'm going to apply my foundation to the rest of my face, including this area here under my eyes. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my BB Flawless, just put a little bit here, give me just a little bit more, and then I'm gonna take our cream concealer in satin and just put a little dot of that there. So you can see there's my cream satin concealer right there. And I'll take my brush and mix the two together and I'm gonna apply it to the rest of my face, including the area under my eyes. And I start in the center of my face and work out. And it's better to start light and build in more coverage. The reason why I do this is because this is going to give me some coverage as it is, and I won't need to use as much concealer and have a less caked on look, hopefully no caked on look, when I get finished. So I'd like a little more coverage, so I'm gonna add just a little more BB Flawless and a touch more concealer. Make sure I have the right color. There we go. Mix it up and tap it on and then blend it out to the rest of my face, including under my eye. Now what I'm doing is I'm going right up to where I applied my makeup, but not all the way up to my lash line. And what this does is it cleans up any fallout from my eyeshadow or any errors or areas where I've gotten sloppy. Okay. Now let's get to work on these under eye circles. The foundation has done some of the work, so I don't have to cover as much. That means less concealer on my eyes. But there's still work to be done. Now, when we have these dark bluish, gray, greenish under eye circles, our tendency is to want to get something lighter and throw it on and think that that'll cover it up. But what that bright light color does is it just creates, on top of dark, an ashy look. So we look more sallow and withdrawn, and it actually makes us look older. Instead, what we want to do is we want to try to correct that color using something with a pinkish undertone or orangish undertone. I use our Touch Cream Concealer in Chiffon, which has those pinky undertones. I don't know if you can see that in this. And what happens is that pinkish orangish tone is somewhat on the opposite end of the color wheel of these greenish dark circles, so it counteracts or corrects those colors. So let's go ahead and start. I'm gonna go ahead and put this here a little bit on the back of my hand, and that allows me to warm it up. And you can either use your finger or you can use a concealer brush to feed it in. If you use a concealer brush, you want a synthetic brush because you're dealing with a cream, and you want it to be pretty stiff, okay, and flat. So that's how much concealer I'm actually using. And again, you start light and build up. Now, what we also do is we also sometimes just kind of like go right under here. But where we are actually the darkest is in this section of our eye. So we want to start here and tap it down and then feather it out. So I get a little concealer on my brush and I'm going to start here in this darkest area. And where you first put your brush is where you're going to apply the most cosmetic product. And you're just going to kind of lightly feather it down and pull it down along that line. And out. And I'm coming again up to where the bottom of my makeup is, but not much beyond that. And I'll blend it down, warm it up with my finger. We also don't want to just stop right here. We want to pull it down in like a Nike swoosh or almost like an inverted triangle. That's going to open up our eye more, brighten our eye. So I'm going to pull it down. Pull it across. Tap it out. So can you see this eye looks brighter, more open? You can see the dark circle here. But this eye, you don't see the circle, and you also don't see that sunken in part. It looks brighter and open, and it's cleaned up my makeup area. I do want to blend it in a little bit more. And it's important just to feather in those edges with the outside of your brush. And that's how you blend it in. If you rub it on and then try to rub it in, it's going to rub off, kind of defeats the purpose of what you're trying to do. And there you have it.